Hello everyone. Do you know how many thoughts we have per day? Well, they are, according to research, around 60,000 to 80,000 thoughts in our mind that run every day. And that comes to 2,500 to maybe 3,300 thoughts an hour and 25 to 50 thoughts a minute. So imagine, if you have so many thoughts in your mind, will you be able to focus on what you are doing? And if you pay attention to these thoughts, you will realize that most of these thoughts are useless and unimportant. It's like a busy train station on an airport terminal where a great number of people go and come regularly. So imagine, with such huge amount of traffic jam, will your mind work properly? Will it be able to focus on what you are learning? Definitely not. So when you sit to study or sit to solve a problem, you are not able to do so properly and in time because your mind is distracted. Because of these number of thoughts that you are having, one thought per second almost. So it becomes impossible to learn. So if a teacher has given you, say, a chapter to learn, which you could have easily learned, maybe in half an hour, but because of these thoughts in our mind, you are devoting more than 2 hours to learn that particular chapter. So, you know, Swami Vivekananda says that mind is like a monkey. A monkey always keeps on jumping from here and there. It's like a butterfly from one flower to another flower. And we are not able to focus. But if we have a concentrated mind, that means if you can reduce the number of thoughts in your mind, gradually your ability to focus and concentration will be much, much better. Exam time now. All of you want to study hard. You want your memory to work better. You want your concentration to be better. Only this will happen if your mind is having less number of thoughts. The more number of thoughts, the lesser your memory will work, the lesser focus and concentration you will have. So it's inversely proportional. In yoga, children, we have certain practices which will help you to develop that focus, that concentration, and that unending stream of thought gradually reduces and your memory also becomes better. The more thoughts you have, the memory will not work. So it's exam time. Let's learn how to concentrate. So in yoga, as I told you, there are a number of practices which is known as dharana or concentration, which comes before meditation. Here we learn from number of thoughts how we can focus on a single thought. It's a practice that we have to develop. And in yoga, it is called Trataka. It is also one of the cleansing practices, a part of Shat Kriyas. So today we are going to learn Trataka, where a number of thoughts, we will try to make them less and focus our mind on a single thought. But before we do that, we have to do eye exercises, which we have already done in one of the sessions when I was doing that session with you where eyes get a lot of pain and we have to focus being online all the time. So first we will relax our eye muscles and then we will go for those practices in Trataka. So before doing Trataka, let us relax our eyes, prepare it for further concentration. So we will do some eye exercises. You can sit straight. You can sit on the chair. Why I am doing it on the chair? Because these exercises are very simple. The Trataka which I am doing, you can do it sitting on the chair. So you don't have to take pains to sit down all the time. You can sit on the bed and do it. You can sit on the chair and do it. You can sit on the floor and do it. So let's see these eye exercises. So all of you sit down, back straight. We will start with eyeball movement up and down to relax our eyes first. So up, down, up, down, up. down, up, down, up, down. Remember, don't move your neck, only move your eyeballs up and down, 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 up and down. Close your eyes. Now do pame. Make a small hollow like this on your palms and put it on your closed eyes. And breathe in and out deeply. Slowly bring your hands down. Keep your eyes closed and open your eyes with a number of blinks. Now we will move our eyeballs left and right. Remember not to move your neck. Your neck remains still, shoulder remains still, only the eyeballs move. So left and right movements. Left, right, 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 left, right. Close your eyes gently. Rub your palms. And do palming. Slowly bring your hands down, eyes remain closed. Open your eyes with a number of blinks. Now we will rotate our eyeballs round clockwise and anti-clockwise 10 times each. So let's start. Clockwise direction, just like the needles of a clock, moving clockwise direction 12, 3, 6 and 9. Close your eyes. For a second, again open your eyes, anti-clockwise this time, 12, 9 and 6, 3. Remember not to rotate your neck remains still, only the eyeballs which are moving. Very good. Close your eyes. Palming again. This time, along with palming, we will do Bhramari. Breathe in. Breathe in again. Down in your studies. Okay, so let's start. We will start with right hand and right thumb. So all of you bring your right thumb in front of you with the right thumb here, the right hand. Focus your eyes on a particular point on the thumb. I am focusing on the tip, top tip of the thumb, and I keep looking at it without blinking and start moving it. Slowly I bring it back. See, my eyes have started watering. And I close my eyes and I do palming. Eyes watering means your focus has been actually very good. And then I do my palming. Deep breathe in and out. And bring your hands down. Relax a bit. And open your eyes with a number of blinks. Now we go to the left side. So here we take the left arm hand in front of you with the left thumb straight here, and again you are going to focus on any one point on your thumb. So let's start. Focus on a point, keep on looking at it. Slowly start. See, the movement has to be very slow. Don't move it very fast. Bring it back. Close your eyes and do farming. My eyes have started watering. So this is right side, this is left side. Try not to blink as far as possible. It is going to help you. Now we go for the next one, which is moving the hand up and focusing there. So again, you bring your right hand in front of you, focus on one particular point and slowly start raising it up only till a point where your vision goes. Continue gazing. Slowly bring it down. Close your eyes and do palming. Remember not to rub your palms, not to rub your eyes when you do palming. Many people have a habit of rubbing their eyes. Please don't rub your eyes, just put it on your eyeballs. Breathe in and out deeply. Hands down, eyes closed. Open your eyes with a number of blinks. So we did right, we did left, we did up, and now we are going to do it down. So once again, you can take right hand, you can take left hand, whichever is okay. I'm using my left hand. I choose a focus once again on the thumb and start looking at it, and slowly I move it down. Keep looking at it. Slowly bring it. Keep on looking at it. Bring your hand down. See, my eyes have started watering. The focus has been very good. It is also an indication that you are cleansing your eyes. It's a part of Shat Kriya, six Kriyas or cleansing techniques in Hatha Yoga as they are mentioned. Do your palming. Bring your hands down. Open your eyes with a number of blinks. So, we did right side, we did left side, we did up and we did down. And now we are going to focus on the tip of our nose, which I have already taught you before. And then on the middle of your eyebrows, which we have already done, but we'll repeat it once again. So let's start. You are going to focus on the tip of your nose. That is the object over here, without blinking your eyes as long as possible. The indication that you should close your eyes is your eyes start watering. Okay, so let's do it. I'm focusing here on the tip of the nose. Close your eyes. A very strong pranayama it is, a very strong trataka it is. Bring your hand down. एंड नाउ वी गो फॉर भ्रूमध्य और द मिडिल ऑफ द आईब्रो. सो दिस इज द पॉइंट यू आर गोइंग टू फोकस विद आईज ओपन. सो प्लीज लुक एट माई आईज वेयर दे गो. आई स्टार्ट. So here it is. Don't do it like this or don't do it like this. It's a straight looking here. So both your eyeballs will look in the middle of the eyebrows. A very, very strong Trataka concentration practice. Close your eyes. And do your part. Down, eyes closed. Now open your eyes with a number. Open your eyes with a number of blinks. So this is one of the ways in which you can children start practicing concentration. One of the best practices to concentrate. And to end it, you can practice Bhramari, which actually relaxes your mind. And once mind is relaxed, thought become less, your memory works better, which is needed for exams, and your concentration is better to focus on your studies to give your exams. So we shall chant Bhramari 3 times and we end the session along with. But please do practice every day. It hardly takes any time, children. And you will come out with wonderful results. It not only increases concentration, focus and memory, it also reduces your eyesight, myopia and hypermetropia. That is, if you have minus power or plus power, you are using spectacles. If you do these practices daily, your spectacles will become thinner. Okay? So we'll end up with Bhramari. Breathe in deeply. Close your eyes. Have a smiling face. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.